Please get ready for dictation of part 2 of exercise 5. 5 seconds. Start. At the present moment, it is clear that not only have we in India no national independence, but we are hedged in and obstructed by numerous restrictions, limitations, safeguards, and reservations which block the path to planning and progress. Our plan for national development must therefore be drawn up for a free and independent India. Thanks to the sacrifices made by millions of our countrymen and countrywomen under the leadership of the father of the nation, Mahatma Gandhi, we have today secured complete sovereign political independence at a time when the nations of the world were engaged in the bitterest struggle, using all the weapons of destruction. If therefore we have secured political independence during the period of a quarter of a century, it should not be difficult, especially when we are today masters in our own country, to secure a socialist pattern of society, as has already been indicated. But it requires the assistance, the propaganda, the active work of all those who are interested in this. I am sure, so long as my honorable friends, the minister, the deputy minister, and the other minister who represent the commerce and industry ministry, can give us an assurance that the capitalist pattern would be avoided, some of us who believe in a 100% socialist democracy give an undertaking that certainly totalitarian policy will not be introduced in this country, because we have believed all along during the fight that we have given to the British government when we secured political independence, that we shall try to maintain democracy undiluted and a socialist democracy at that. I am absolutely certain that in this country of ours, liberty of thought, liberty of speech, and liberty of action will be guaranteed to every citizen to express his views in the manner he pleases. I therefore assure my honorable friend that so long as we do not, in the garb of a socialist pattern, support a capitalist system, India will stand 100% for a socialist democracy. Now, luckily for us, the fundamental rights of the Constitution have declared that a citizen would be assured of many of the social amenities which will give reasonable comfort from the womb to the grave. But mere enunciation, as I have said many times, will not satisfy the common man unless the saying is put into effect. I am absolutely certain, therefore, that so long as there is determination on the part of our countrymen, we will be in a position to secure a socialist pattern of society. It is not even possible to draw up a plan on any other basis. Stop.